Hello friends, my name is Sushil Singh and today I am going to discuss how to install SQL Server on your machine. As I have set up of SQL Server 2014, you may have another versions of SQL Server, but mostly steps are same for the installation. So you have to follow all these steps and you can install SQL Server on your machine. Before going forward, I would recommend if you don't have Microsoft .NET Framework 3.5 Service Pack 1 on your machine, you have to download it and install it first. Otherwise, you will not able to install SQL. You have installed Microsoft .NET Framework 3.5 Service Pack 1. You should open your setup and double click on Setup exe. Once you have double click, it will open. It will take few seconds. It will open SQL Server Installation Center. Once you will get SQL Server Installation Center, then go to the installation. Inside the installation, you have to choose the first option, that is New SQL Server Instant Alone Installation or Add Features to the Existing Installation. You have to click on it and it will redirect to another window. It will take few seconds. You have to wait until it will not be open. Once it will open, then once you will get this screen, you can see there is several steps like product key, license terms, global rules. You have to follow all these steps one by one. And on my first, you can see it's a product key. You have a specified product key for your setup. So on my case, I have entered. Simply click on next. In the second, I have to accept the license term. So I'll check on this checkbox and click on next. Then it will check for the global rules if all these will be okay for our requirement. It will move forward. It will take time in setup files. It's taking time. Yes, installation rule. And inside the installation rule, you can find out it's showing a warning. Warning is Windows Firewall. It's Windows Firewall is not off. So we have to turn off the Windows Firewall. Go to the control panel and go to the Windows Firewall and then turn off the Windows Firewall. Once you will turn off the firewall and then go to the setup and click on rerun, it will move forward. In setup roles, we don't want to default. All features will default. We want SQL Server feature installation. I'll select what feature we want to install. So click on next. Here it will ask us what service you want to install. Database engine service or database reporting services and SQL Server integration services. What type of service you want to install? On my case, I want to install all these services and then click next. It's taking time. Here, default instance and name instance. If you are going to install for your local machine, you can choose the default instance. If you are going to install for any another machine, you have to choose the name instance. Only one you can install with a single name by default instance. If you want to create one more instance, you have to specify name instance. Default will be disabled when you are going to install once more. So I'm going to by default. Then click on next. It's taking time. Yes, so it's again taking time. Yeah, in server configuration, you have to very take care for the server configuration. Here we can see the setup type. Setup type should be automatic for all these SQL agent, database engine, analysis services, reporting services, integration services. these are the very important part. So we have to set a type, should be automatic. Rest of the you can choose manual. Go to the collision, and inside the collision database engine, you have to select our first option, which is SQL underscore 1x compat underscore CP850 underscore CI underscore AS. I'll discuss this later in this video series why we are going to use this database engine collision. For this, click next. Here we want put user ID and password. User ID should be SA for system administrator, and we want enter some password for the same. So we have to choose the mix mode and enter the password. So I have enter over here, and then click on add current user. When this user will be added, click on next. Click on next. Okay. Here in analysis services configuration, you have to choose the add a user. You can use add a user. Next. For the reporting services, you don't need to change anything. You have to simply click on next. Here you have to add current user and then click on next. In distributed system, if your controller is another from this system, then you have to specify the controller name and choose the directory. Otherwise, skip this. For my case, this is our controller. There is no any controller, so click on next. Now it's taking time. So it's ready to install. We have to click on install. So you can see there is installation process is going forward. It will take around half an hour. So I am going to pause, and once it will be completed, then I'll show the next. Now you can see SQL Server has been installed successfully. So you can close it and you can open. You can search by using SQL Server, and it will be open. SQL Server Management Studio 2014. Click on it. It's going to take few seconds because it's loading first time. Once it will be loaded, you can log in directly by using Windows authentication, or you can log in by using mix mode, as we have specified the password. So you can enter user ID and password. So now it has been successfully completed. I hope now you can understand how to install SQL Server. So thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe our channel for many more videos.